Hello, welcome to Look Talks. This is Dr. Lokesh Bhatia. Dear friends, today I'll be talking to you on another topic on relationship on control freaks. If any one of you who has experienced such a controlling partner, you will be able to relate to my today's topic. Those who haven't got any experience might be that they might not have pointed it out, but yes, they can very well make out and understand what am I talking about. So, see you again after a break of few seconds.
Namaskar, main Dr. Lokesh Bhatia. Subscribe karein Look Talks channel ko, professional medical guidance ke liye, spirituality and meditation ke liye, and life coaching sessions ke liye. Yeh hai mera WhatsApp number, aap kabhi bhi sampark kar sakte hain. Dhanyawad.
So, what are the control freaks and what are their 8 signs? If you are control freak, you can make out very well. Control freaks rarely know that they are control freaks. That's the beauty of it, that they rarely know that they are control freaks. And they believe that they are helping people with their constructive criticism or taking over a project because no one else would do it right. They don't see their controlling behaviors as the symptoms of what's really going on. Their own anxiety has run amok. Irrational thoughts abound in our high stress world. Now let's see some examples. Like, if I don't get this contract, I'll get fired. If I'm not home by 6, I am a terrible parent. If I don't get that raise, I suck at my job. All of these thoughts might be true, but probably not. Rather than tackle our own irrational thinking and convert it into more realistic thinking, we attempt to control the situation, usually to trying to control other people. So, want to know if you are a control freak? Here are 8 signs of your self-diagnosing pleasure. You believe that if someone would change one or two things about themselves, you will be happier. So you try to help them change this behavior by pointing it out, usually over and over again and again. So that's the first sign that you think that X or Y quality one should change, and then you'll be more happier. The second sign is you micromanage others to make them fit your expectations. Now, this in one word can also be named as manipulation. You don't believe in imperfection and you don't think that anyone else should be either way. So this is something very important to understand if you are trying to govern the world the way you want it, or that they should stick to your thought process. People are, the very standard thinking to make oneself comfortable is that people and situations are not going to be my way. The day we decide and accept this reality of life, one can be very comfortable. But this kind of control freak people never think like that. And they become very much controlling in their attitudes and their behaviors. Then the third sign is that you judge others. You judge others' behavior as right or wrong and passive aggressively withhold attention until they fall in line with your expectations. Sitting in silent judgment is a master form of control. When you try to judge others and you expect that this is how one they should be behaving, they should be thinking, that's the sign of a controlling behavior. The fourth sign is you offer a constructive criticism as a veiled attempt to advance your agenda. Right? So that's a fourth sign. Fifth sign is you change who you are or what you believe so that someone will accept you. Instead of just being yourself, you attempt to incept others by managing their impression of you. Sixth sign is you present worst case scenarios. In an attempt to influence some way from certain behaviors and towards others. This is also called fear mongering. Let's understand this point again. You present worst case scenarios. You tell people such stories which people tend to believe in, and in order to make people believe whatever you are trying to tell them, to convince them. The seventh point is you have a hard time with ambiguity and being okay with not knowing something. You must have seen a lot of people will try to pose a lot of things. Even if they don't know it, they will still pose as if they know everything. And such people will always be very much creating kind of ambiguity. It's very difficult for them to accept they are not at all okay with not knowing something, right? So the last sign is you intervene on behalf of people by trying to explain or dismiss their behaviors to others. You believe that if you can change another person's undesirable behavior, then you will be happier or more fulfilled. You make someone else responsible for how you feel. The thing is, you are the one and only one responsible for your feelings. The road to better relationships always starts with you. Rather than attempt to control everyone else, work on becoming a better version of yourself. Here are a few ideas. Be vulnerable with people. Never compromise your self-respect by altering your core beliefs. Be realistic about your expectations of others. Quit the passive-aggressive nonsense and be direct. Accept that a large portion of life is laced with unknowns. A lot of times we don't know what is the right thing and what are the right people, but it's okay, it's fine. We still believe the world. Take responsibility of your own happiness. When you try to depend your happiness on someone else, and because someone else might be unhappy with his own world, he will try to make you unhappy and you become unhappy because he is unhappy. You are getting how the vicious cycle sets in. So even if somebody else is unhappy, should not make a difference to you. You should be knowing the fact that he or she is unhappy. You cannot push that unhappiness within you, right? So take responsibility of your own happiness. If you work on your own improvement instead of trying to control others, healthier relationships at work as well as everywhere else will then come to you as a result. So this is all very important for all of you to understand, that the control freaks may be within you, control freaks may be around you. But knowing this kind of behavior of people can help you and help you also to your own self, that if you are a control freak, you must understand what you are doing and you should try to get rid of that kind of attitude. Trying to change others, trying to work on others' habits, trying to improve others. No need of it. Right? Thank you. Thank you very much. I hope you could appreciate these points. You could understand what I'm trying to convey you, and try to work out and improvise your life for a better today and better tomorrow and your better future. Thank you very much. Bye-bye. All the best. God bless you. Take care. Don't forget to share this video with your friends. If you liked it, click on thumbs up. And do subscribe Look Talks, and don't forget to hit on the bell icon. Thank you very much. Bye-bye.